What's up, guys? It's Chase from Chase's Workshop, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use Fusion 360 to make a template without a CNC machine. If it sounds like something interests you, give me a like. If you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys. All right, guys, so here we are. Here's the program, and we're going to go through it real quick, and we're going to just make a drawing out of this to where you can use this to print out a template to where you can just use it to stick on a set if you don't have a CNC machine. So the first thing we're going to do is we've found a picture online that we want to make use for our pickup router template. And so we're going to go here to Insert, right here. We're going to go to Attached Canvas, and we're going to attach our canvas to the top right here. We want to be in the top orientation. And click, once we do that, and now we're going to select our image. If you see right here, it says Select Image. Click on that. We're going to come down here to the one that we want to use, which is this one. And so now our image is in our program. We're going to click OK. Now if we use this right here, it's going to be tiny because it's not calibrated. So the next thing we have to do is we have to come here to Canvases and go to our pickup route and hit Calibrate right here. And once we do that, we're going to click, hold on. I don't know why it keeps doing this. I need to zoom in closer when I do this for some reason. I think it's because I'm trying to record the screen and everything else. So, Calibrate. We're going to come here and we're going to click right as close as we can get to the corner of this one, as close as we can get to the corner of this one. And as you can see down here, it's 75 millimeters. Now, if you're in inches, if you're using inches for your program, make sure you type in 75mm, not 75. You do 75, it's going to make it 75 inches, and it's going to be huge. So we're going to type in 75mm, and we're going to hit Enter. It's going to blow it up to the right size now. And the next thing we're going to do is we're going to come here to Sketch, right here. Sketch, we're going to create a sketch. We're going to use our top orientation again, like we did here, and we're going to use a 2-point rectangle. You can come in here and use a 2-point, 3-point center rectangle, circle, arc, however, whatever you're designing, you can use it here. So we'll come here. We're just going to click this top one right here for a 2-point rectangle, and we're going to start it as close as we can to our line here. Let me go back. I don't know why this thing won't let me zoom when I'm. So we'll come back here, and we're going to click as close as possible. Now instead of just coming here and clicking here and being done with it, we want to be more exact than that. So as you can tell, our side is 30 millimeters right here, and the bottom is 75 millimeters. So we're going to come here and click this, and instead of just coming over here and clicking done, you see where it's highlighted on the left here, where it says 1.182 inches. We're going to change that to the 30 millimeters of our height of our project. So 30, and make sure you put the mm in there. And then we're going to hit Tab, and it's going to go to the top one. And at the bottom for the top side, it's 75 millimeters, so we're going to hit 75mm. So hit Enter. And you can see pretty much how accurate this is. It's a little bit off, but that's why I do this instead of just doing it as a square box. It's going to be off if you're trying to make an exact part for that. So we're going to do the same thing for these little square sides right here. We're going to come in here and we're going to click on this, and we're going to drag to here, and our box is 15 millimeters, 15mm, and we're going to tab and do 15mm and hit Enter. Now instead of just coming over here and doing the same box, like I said a while ago, we're going to make this as accurate as possible, is we're going to come here and we're going to add what's called a mirror. And to get to that, all you have to do is with anything in Fusion 360, you hit S, it brings up a search sketch toolbox, and you can type in what you want. So I'm wanting to use a thing called a mirror, so M-I-R-R, and it automatically populates and gives me a mirror right here. So I click on that, and it's going to bring up this box. It's going to ask me two things. It's saying, what are the objects that I want to mirror? Okay, I want to mirror these objects right here, these four right here. Okay, and then it's going to ask me, what do I want to use as the mirror line? Where's my mirror going to be? And in order to use that, I have to do one more thing. I have to come here and put a line right here. And it has to be center. If I use this line, it's going to just put it right next to it. So I have to come in here. If you take your cursor and go to a line right here, and follow the top of this to it gets to the center. It's going to make a triangle on an X right there when it gets to the center of that box, and just do a 90 degree line. You don't have to go all the way across it. It can if you want it to. So we'll go back now and hit S, mirror. As you can see, it's already in here too. If you wanted to just, once you do it, once you use it a few times, it brings it up. All right, what objects do I want to mirror? I want to mirror these. And where's my line at that I want to mirror? I want to mirror it off of this line here. And as you can see, it brings up that box over there. So it's that simple on that. Now that we have all that set, we can actually get rid of our drawing in the background. And to do that, all we do is come over here to this pickup route to where our attached canvases, and we click this one off. You can also click this one off here. But if you have more than one picture in there that you're going with, you need to do them individually. So now we've got our actual drawing right here. We want to clean this up a little bit, and to do that, we're going to use a thing called trim. And to get to it, you can hit T on your keyboard. That's the easiest way to get to it. And it brings up this little, on your cursor, it puts the little, I don't know what that is, like an X on the bottom of it. And you come here and it's going to highlight. So you come here and delete these out. And now we're to where it looks a lot like just a regular pickup. Now the next thing I want to add to this is just some fillets. And all a fillet is it just adds a curve to these edges right here. And so I'm going to hit S. I'm going to type in fillet. All right, it automatically populates it. Don't use this one. This one's actually for if you already had it extruded. You'll see what I'm talking about here in just a minute. Use this one for the sketch. So we're going to come here. We're going to click this right here. And whatever size you want it. If you want it, quarter inch. If you want to do a quarter inch, I'm going to do an eighth inch. So you can actually come in here and just type in a 1/8. And it's going to give you an eighth inch fillet. And you come in here and you click on the rest of them. Before you press enter, make sure you click on the ones that you want. And then hit enter. And now we are basically have our pickup designed. Our pickup route template designed. One thing I do on here a lot too is I get rid of these points and the constraints because it kind of just clogs up, makes it hard to view the sketch and everything. And if you're having trouble, like especially with your drawing of it centered on one part that you're trying to get, come right here to this snap and click it off, and you have a lot more control of getting on different lines for your drawing. Okay, now that we've got this, we're going to actually go in here and we're going to make the part that the actual router is going to sit on. And to do that, all we're going to do is just come in here and do a center point rectangle. And we'll try to get as close as we can with it. It don't have to be exact, but we're just going to come in here and move this thing out. And you can do it like this if you're going to make just a template that we're going to do for this project. So we'll just make it 2 inches by 5 inches. Hit enter. Okay, so there's that. Now the last step we have to do to get this thing to where we can put it to print it out on something is we have to extrude it. And to do that, you can hit E. You can come to create right here. You can go to extrude. You can do the S, hit extrude. However you want to do it. And the way I always do it is I just hit E. Let me get rid of this box here. I just hit E. And it's going to highlight whichever one you want. So if we want this one, if you're going to use this with the CNC, you need to this is the point you need to put in what the thickness of the stock you're going to be using for it. If we're just going to print it out on a piece of paper, you can do the thickness however thick, you can do it at 0.01 inch. It's gonna make the part. So we'll try that. We'll just say 0.05. So we have our drawing here now. Now our pickup cavity is our router template's done to actually print to a piece of paper. And the way we get to that part of the process is you come in here to model where it says model, and come down here to drawing, and you do a drawing from the design. Now, in order to make the drawing, you have to have saved this, your project that you're doing now. So this is actually saving the project. So I want to save it as just pickup router drawing. Okay, now it's going to give me create a drawing here. We're going to do a full assembly. We're going to create a new from scratch. We're going to use standard measurements in inches. And this is where, like, if you're doing something really big, a really big project, you might want to, you know, come in here and go to 44 by 34, however big you want it. We're going to just use the regular size sheet of paper for this right here. So I'll click on that, click OK. Hopefully it comes out great. Now, when you first bring this in here, you're going to be like, why is that just a line? But all you got to do is just take it. It's actually showing, if you look over here at the orientation of this, it's showing as the front. And we're just going to come here and place it in here and go to top orientation. So now you can see it actually looks like what we want. All right, and the next thing here is the scale. We need to do a 1-to-1 scale. So now our actual drawing is right with the program, or right with the right size we want. So once we print this out, it'll be the right size. And then hit OK. So now you have your drawing. You can come in here and you can add dimensions to it if you want to. You can come here and click here, it'll give you all the different, there's 5 inches, it'll give you here to here, 2 inches, if you want to know from here to here, it gives you 3.53, and basically all you do now is take this right here, export it out as a PDF, or however you want to export it out, and then print it out. And the really cool thing about the PDF is that, you know, if you do a really big project, like say you're making a guitar template, and you know you can't fit a whole guitar on one little sheet of paper. Where you can print it out using PDFs, you can print it out as tiles, where you take them and basically stick them all together and use that as your template, and then to make your template with. So it's really versatile. Well, all right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that little crash course in the Fusion 360. One thing I want to say about Fusion is that it's free as long as you make less than $100,000 a year using their program. I didn't have any problem meeting that standard. So also, too, maybe now you can kind of get an idea that just because you don't have a CNC machine doesn't mean you can't use a CAD program to come up with cool parts or come up with templates for stuff that you're doing. You know, I made this template for a guitar because I work on guitars. If you do other things, you can use templates for that. You can make stencils. You can do all kinds of things with this program. So if you have any comments or questions, just leave them below. If you like it, guys, I really appreciate it if you subscribe. Thanks for watching.